Mark Stein is an author and columnist and an actual thinker, and he joins us tonight. So, Mark, when people like the guy we just showed put air quotes around the phrase illegal immigrant, what does that mean? Are you not allowed to admit that they're immigrating illegally?
Yeah, I think he doesn't recognize that category. What's interesting is that both he and Nancy Pelosi and others on that side of the aisle are getting ever more explicit in their preference for illegal immigrants, well, so-called, as he would say, over American citizens. He said, Chris Cuomo went on to say that the real problem is white supremacists in America. They're the real monsters, not these nice, hard-working, illegal immigrants. And that may be well and true. I mean, for the purposes of argument, let's just say he's right. It's irrelevant. The white supremacists are American citizens. The illegal immigrants are people who shouldn't be here. And the organizing principle of nation states is that they're organized on behalf of their citizens, whether their citizens are cheerleaders or white supremacists or whatever. You're stuck with them. And this preference that Nancy Pelosi and Chris Cuomo and increasing people have for actually importing a class of citizen that they prefer to the ones they're stuck with is actually very revealing.
But how can you lead a country whose population you despise? I mean, would you be a good parent if you hated your kids? Would you be an effective officer if you didn't care about the safety of your men? I mean, doesn't that kind of prima facie show that you're not ready to lead if you don't love the people you're leading?
No, I mean, you said, what about parents and kids? Every family, I think it was Malcolm Muggeridge who said that friends are God's apology for relatives. In other words, you pick your friends, you're stuck with your relatives. The Democrats are getting very close to saying that foreigners are God's apology for Americans.
Nancy
Pelosi has explicitly said that we should thank the parents of these so-called dreamers, these DACA people, for bringing them here illegally. And in fact, to go back to what your Swedish guest was saying, you know, whatever the economic benefits, which are minimal and are not evenly distributed, the cultural transformation, which is what's happening in Sweden, other parts of Europe, and is what's happening in Arizona too, that's forever. In Arizona, a majority of the grade school children now are Hispanic. That means Arizona's future is as an Hispanic society. That means, in effect, the border has moved north. And the cultural transformation outweighs any economic benefits that lady was talking about.
It's at the very least bewildering for people who grew up here, and that's real. I don't think you have to be animated by hate or anything to say, you know, maybe I should have some say in how my country evolves. Mark, thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, Tucker.